What we're interested in is social contagion. Mm. How can other sorts of things, how can ideas, norms, behaviors spread from person to person and from person to person to person? Our initial thought was to look at obesity. Could we find evidence that as one person gained weight, it made their friends gain weight, and then their friends' friends and friends' friends and so forth? So these are some results of that study. What we show here is that at one degree of separation, if your friends are obese, you've got about a 45% higher likelihood of being obese yourself.
Right.
And if your friends' friends are obese, you've got a 25% higher likelihood of being obese. And if your friends' friends' friends are obese, you've got a 10% higher likelihood of being obese. And it's only when I get to 4 degrees of separation,
wow,
your friends, 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 friends,
right,
that there's no longer a relationship between that person's body size and your body size.
So the truly amazing thing is that even though you may never have met your friend's friend, their behavior is contagious to you through the friend you have in common. Follow-up studies have demonstrated that whether you drink alcohol or not is contagious within your social network. And so is smoking and taste in music and books. Both happiness and loneliness are contagious too. And yet, we are not consciously aware of any of that, because we're making most of the decisions that shape those behaviors on autopilot. And that is what gives 21st century hackers so much control over whether a group of people functions well or functions poorly. All they have to do is hack into our autopilot system and seed a behavior. And without our even being aware of it, we will spread that behavior throughout our social network, either for good or for ill.
You take a group of people and you assemble them one way with one set of rules of interaction, and those people are kind to each other,
yeah,
or cooperate or innovate or are healthy.
Right.
Or you take the same human beings and connect them a different way and they're none of those things. They're mean to each other. They don't learn from each other. They're unhealthy. They're uninnovative. They're uncooperative. Same human beings connected different ways gives the group different properties. Mm.
Christakis' goal is to design hacks that will help entire societies function better. His latest project is aimed at improving the health of babies in rural Honduras with this simple hack. First, strategically select just a few people in a village. Next, educate them about best practices, like only giving babies clean water. And then count on those people to make that behavior contagious throughout the village.
And in this village over here, you pick 6 people at random, the 6 yellow dots, to whom you're going to give some sort of an intervention, a public health intervention, a clean water intervention,
right,
a vaccination intervention. And what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to understand not what happens to the people to whom you give the intervention, but what everyone else in the village does.
The goal is to create hacks that countries can use to dramatically improve the health of their citizens at a cost they can afford.
For us, the Holy Grail is to be able to provide a kind of multiplication factor for public health interventions, so that we recognize that if we only have so much money and we can only reach 100 people, maybe rather than targeting 100 people in one village, maybe we could target 20 people in each of 5 different villages and still get all 5 villages to change their behavior. And so now we've multiplied by 5 the impact of our intervention by exploiting some of these ideas about behavior change and social embeddedness. Incidentally, the same paradigm can hold not just for villages in the developing world, but for classrooms. We're trying to get kids to not smoke. We're trying to get kids to be studious. We're trying to get them to wear their bicycle helmets. From workplaces, we're trying to increase worker safety. To hospitals, we're trying to get doctors to wash their hands or order fewer tests. This is, in my eye, one of the coolest things you can do in science today.